All right, hello, folks. Hakuna Matata. This is Dmitry Balkovsky of Russian Move, and I was trying to find not a very cheesy like wordplay on roses. So I am in the midst of a bouquet, I suppose, right?
Absolutely.
The entire rose family. Is it only for this video that you're gathered together?
This is the first time that we will all be together speaking.
Oh my
god. There were a few shots in a video where we were in the same shot, but almost no one was talking.
All right, so it's an honor.
Yes.
Hi, hello, and thank you for bringing me into this spacious and welcoming home. I am very glad to see you guys, and what I wanted to do, I just wanted to ask questions, especially the children, because, well, you've seen plenty of Joe and Svetlana, even though I'm sure you cannot be, well, there cannot be too much of them. They're very nice. There is a mix of cultures and backgrounds and everything. So, yeah, I wanted to ask you, ladies and gents, how you're feeling in this great land of ours. Let's start with the patriarch of the family.
That's me.
Mr. Rose, charming Svetlana as always, Josiah.
Feliz Navidad.
Yes, Aurora, of course, Alex, Christoph, and Maxim. So, the whole set. Very nice, very nice.
You got us memorized. You worked on that last night.
Yes. I had a list and I was saying yes. How's Russia treating you guys, Maxim? Could you tell us a little bit?
Maxim.
Okay.
Maxim, я рад. Да, Максим? Максим, ты рад?
Как твой садик?
Максим, ты рад?
I have a three-year-old myself here.
How's your
Christoph?
How do you like Russia?
Christoph, tell us two or three words or four, as many as you wish. What do you think of Russia? In English, though.
Hello, goodbye.
Do you like Russia? Yes or no? Tell him, do you like Russia?
Yes.
Tell him.
And why do you like Russia?
I don't know.
How does it compare to Florida? Russia is like this and Florida is like that.
Russia has
Russia
more
cold
sun.
And okay. America hot.
Okay.
Stow, Christoph?
That's the cold America.
Yeah, I know. Stow is talking. Stow? Say it again. Tell the camera again. Russia is?
Russia is cold and America is hot.
You see? Yeah, wisdom, what was to say?
Very insightful.
From the mouth of a child, what was to, yeah.
From the mouth of babes.
Yeah, mouth of babes. Alex, how's Russia? Is she? She could be, you know, a difficult woman sometimes.
Yes, I could give you a whole hour of me ranting about the difference between the countries, so I'm not...
Good, let's go.
Well, as Christoph just mentioned, Aurora tried to get him to mention, I guess the infrastructure is immediately, it's the first thing that comes to mind. Well, in Moscow, there's a very finely engineered metro system. And in the US, at least where I lived, there was no such thing. And as far as I'm concerned, I haven't been to big cities in the U.S., but I'm sure their underground subway systems are not the same as they are here.
There is no subway in the swamps, you didn't to say?
Well, yeah, you're Florida, I guess not. It's kind of difficult when you're working with limestone.
You were born in Russia, right? And
yes.
You guys moved to the States.
Yes.
What makes you feel warm in the States and in Russia? Like, what do you like? What's your, like, number one like in both places?
Right. Well, in the States, it would be, I guess, Florida. What makes me feel warm is also, how Christoph mentioned, it's a little warmth.
Right.
Florida's a warm state, has very tropical, and I do really like the nature there and the things that grow around you. I guess the swamps. It is very beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
So that's probably the first thing also that comes to mind as far as Florida that makes me feel very warm.
Okay.
With Moscow, I think it's definitely the historical center of the city.
Right.
I've been there many times, but I could go again. And often I think when I'm walking past, I think to myself, maybe I should just take a day to walk around and go wherever my feet take me. I haven't done that yet, but hopefully soon I'm able to.
Both places appeal to you. Well, that's very nice. That's very nice. Because I spent 3 years in the States in the 90s. And I still remember, you know, nice things about Boston. I have good memories, actually. I spent 2 years in New Zealand and 3 years in the States. In the States, yeah, they were, I don't know, warmer people, especially in the Midwest. The nearer you go to the coast, the like more city-like folks get. But in Wisconsin and Minnesota, yeah, they're very... It was good.
And for us, it's kind of cool because we got to spend many years in a small town, warm, tropical, vacation type, old dacha type environment.
Right.
And then we got to move here, which is like colder, big, historic city. So for us, there's a contrast, but not in a negative way.
Aurora, you go to school here, right? To Moscow State? Like you're a sophomore or?
I just finished my first year.
Okay. So you don't have an American college experience here, no?
People usually ask me to compare
Right. So how is Moscow State? I tried to enter Moscow State twice, and the second time I did worse than the first time.
Yeah,
very, very, very nice record in that.
So community. She's better than you in one small way.
Oh, many ways. But I would think that they like you there. It's Russian big city kids. They like people from somewhere far away. They enjoy the country. So
I hope they like me, but I don't know. The students, we get along. They usually help me out if I don't understand something in Russian. Even my class are in English and in Russian. And they'll often be more assigned to read something in Russian and go, I couldn't find the name translation, something in American. It's really sweet. And a few times I've gone on walks with them, just on campus, it's a good time. I don't know if the teachers like me very much, especially the ones who speak English, because I could be a better student in those classes, but I don't necessarily care to practice my English in my English classes. But other than that, I think the teachers like me. I'm having a good time. The schedule's nice. I don't have classes on Saturday, which leaves my weekend free. And the classes last an hour and a half long, which is not too long, but also not too short, and it's very productive. And so I'm getting a lot of information, which is cool.
Right. Is it political science that you're studying?
No, I'm on...
The literature and linguistics. Yes.
Not right. Literature, but just teaching foreign languages.
Okay. All right. So the quality is how do you?
I like it. I think that the kids or the other students around me, they're super smart and. Yes, smart. They handle it very well. Their vocabulary might be higher than mine, but
in English.
In English, they always use large words. I'm like, oh, you guys are so cool.
You're too kind to us, Russians.
But I take French there, and I'm learning French and Russian, and the classes are at a very fast pace, and it was a bit difficult at first. I think I'm catching on now, but I think it's very good quality, and you have to stay focused and stay on top of all of your assignments and really study by yourself to pass exams.
So So you enjoy it?
I enjoy it.
Well, that's good. Yeah, that's right. All right.
Wait, now don't forget, these two are very humble. They already starred in the video on the Expat American channel together, Moscow After Midnight.
Oh, yes. You remember, yeah.
Yes, quite popular, Dimitri and Aurora.
Cold March evening, yes. I do recall. All right, great. So, Josiah, the man behind the camera.
Greetings.
The yes. Comedy sidekick.
Yes. So, how do you find, did you study as well?
I did study. I'm currently studying. I'm improving my Russian. It's been good overall. I'd say I never attended university or college in Florida. I did visit a lot. I've got friends that currently so I can point out some differences. For one thing, unlike my American friends, I've never had a classmate get expelled for taking horse tranquilizers. I hate snow.
Okay.
I'm Mr. Heatmeister. I cannot say snow. Yeah, okay, but we're from Florida, and this is the only foreign country I've been to. So I can say what I want. I hate snow. This is a problem. Russia, you gotta fix it.
That's not
good. Well, finally, we have some, you know, it's all, you know, women peaches, and yeah, good, Josiah, good go.
I get that some people like snow, and that's fine, but there needs to at least be like a legal limit to it.
Okay.
Yeah, talk to God about that.
Like 18 plus or something, yeah.
I'd say 2 inches is fine.
Okay.
Well, seriously, is it true in the very center, like the historic center, is there so much metro and machines and heat that the snow melts pretty quickly?
Yeah. It's always warmer in the center and in town when you go outside. It's like minus 10 degrees, I think.
Because
yeah.
I've noticed that spending winters here is whenever I go into like Red Square and near that area, I'm like, oh, the snow's not really here.
Yeah, well, they clean it.
They're cleaning it,
I guess. Yeah.
Is it just that they're cleaning it, or is it also the heat that's
It's the heat and then cleaning. Yeah. Our mayor is trying to, you know, keep up appearances, and when you're somewhere in the suburbs, it's not as snow-free as as in the center. So, that's nice. That's my style. Say something that you don't like. I know Russia's great.
They can talk about the nice stuff.
You go. All right.
Food. I get it. I'm from Florida. I'm half Mexican. I'm used to having lots and lots of spices. I don't put spices on my food. I have food with my spices.
Okay. It's good for your liver. Yeah.
It's good for my tongue and my heart. I love the bakery dishes, the carne, the ones from Central Asia that get the stand and the light.
Okay.
They are very, very flavorful. Samsa is fantastic. Kashpuri is fantastic. Everything else, you got to step up your game. We need more seasonings here.
Okay. So like a pound of pepper in your borscht, right?
I have red pepper, and I put it on my pomen.
Okay, good. That's not talking. All right. Do you guys have, like, I'm sure you have friends, like the three big roses?
Oh, I'm so lonely.
The three big roses have friends.
Christoph Musk is too young to be lonely. What's your
friend ratio?
Proportion. What's the do you keep up with the Americans better or Russians? How do you have like a best friend here or?
I keep up with two friends from the U.S. like every 2 to 3 months. We'll message each other.
Uh-huh.
Sometimes it's a short conversation like, "Hi, I'm good to see you. I love you. I don't have time to talk right now because I'm busy with the university. I'm gonna forget about you." Or they'll message the same thing, and from the U.S. we'll occasionally message each other, but not so much. It's hard for me to text people.
I
think it's hard for me to do long distance anything because when you're doing things in person, realize it sort of gives you a reason to talk to them and something to connect to each other on a physical level as well.
Right.
So I try to keep up with my U.S. friends. Sometimes, I will text them. They'll text me like once a month. Like, hey, what's up? Any new life updates or anything? I think it's like probably like five friends maximum. Just because I guess so far away, there's not many things connected and stuff. So I'm kind of like, if I'm not there and seeing a person constantly, the probability that I'm going to talk to them decreases.
Okay. And, but you guys both have friends here, right?
Yes.
Josiah, you probably don't. Nobody likes pepper here.
Surprisingly, I have a few friends here.
Of spice. Okay.
Yeah. I am generally friendly and good interacting with people, even if I'm an introvert. So yeah, I've got people that I call friends, people that I call acquaintances in Russia and Moscow and a couple other cities as well. I have always been very bad at keeping in contact with people. So a lot of people that I would consider a friend, at this point, they would probably just consider me somebody who I'm not. Because for me, time makes no difference on these kinds of relationships, and that's not true for other people. So I'm bad at maintaining that connection. And the same goes for friends in America. It's been so long, and I do feel bad about it, so sorry for any Americans that knew me and considered me a friend. I still think of you as a friend.
So you can call someone like 2 years, like, you know, like
more than 2 years.
Like you saw him yesterday.
Yeah. One time I forgot to contact Aurora for like 3 months when I lived here and she lived there. And when we finally did talk, I thought it was like a week.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, because he came here 3 years before us.
Oh, right.
It was an island for a while there.
Right.
And then for me, time differences, and I already mentioned it, just doesn't do anything. On the other hand...
Luckily, I was not offended. I know that he's like this.
Thank you.
He doesn't answer.
On the other hand, I'm what's called a gamer, the next step in human evolution. So I'm used to playing with people from around the world in online games.
Okay.
And I have friends from around the world, even if I don't know their legal name. I do consider them a friend, and they consider me a friend likewise.
Right.
And that includes America, some of which I do know their own names. Those friends I relatively keep talking
to. Okay.
I will say, on a serious note, I have lost many American friends living here. And that's not an exaggeration. And I have not had any arguments with anyone, but I think it's a testament to how powerful the mainstream media is, the Western mainstream media is. And this is a generalization. I still have friends. I still have people that keep in contact with me and like me and are friendly with me. But for the most part, since the over a year that I've been here, you know, I would get emails, oh my gosh, are you okay? And they're very concerned for me. And they're like, I heard this in the news, I heard that. And they're thinking I'm in
the trenches already.
This terrible place. And then I tell them how wonderful it is, how everything's okay, and then I get no email back. Now, this isn't everybody, and those who are still my friends, you know who you are, but I'd say 90% this has been the case. You know, well, I mean, some people don't contact me at all, but they'll send an email, I'll tell them how great it is, and then they don't email me back, like, wow, really, Joe? And they don't. It's not like they care to know, they're just like, okay, I guess Joe has been brainwashed. I tried to save him, and he doesn't understand, so I'm done.
Let me address Joe's friends in America. Please write him back, because, you know, he's completely... His eyes are not like glassy and white, like, you know, in those horror movies. He's completely sane and, you know, looking nice, feeling nice, and, you know, very, very nice environment here. Svetlana, so how are you doing? What does it feel like to be a mom in the United States?
I think it's probably the same what I'm enjoying the most is the ability to speak my own language finally and listen around. The people are speaking the same language. It's really nice. So my children went to, Christoph went to school and Maxine went to kindergarten. It's also something unusual for me because they were legal and they were with me all the time. For instance, now I'm enjoying now being educated.
Right. But you've said it before, but I'm sure you feel like comfortable about them being here, about all the, entire, all the five of them being, you know, safe and sound.
Oh yeah, I'm so grateful that we are all together. I think we don't have this. I really want to take it away. Because I was living there for 9 years, and I thought it was great. But I wanted to have a different experience with whole community to become my motherland.
Interesting time that we decided to have a new experience right before the world changed.
Yes. The motherland was calling you softly. Yes. And you came. All right, so I want to thank you guys for sharing all this with me and with our dearest viewers. So, as you can see, American family, Russian-American, comfy, nice, not brainwashed, no, like, manacles or barnacles or something. So, all right, thank you very much, our viewers. Please subscribe, like, and we have a link to Joe's and Svetlana's and the Rose family channel in the description. Please visit them, watch their videos. They have very nice videos, unlike this channel. You know, they do a lot of editing. I'm not good at editing, so I'm just giving you some raw stuff. Oh, here we have like a piece of real news, CNN.